previously made when creating freeways around in the area. And I'm here in this video to explain why. So for starters, the Sun Gateway project is a project that's along the freeways of I-35E and US 67 south of downtown Dallas. It starts on I-35E south of I-30 and goes all the way to Overton, I think Overton Road. And on US 67, it goes all the way from its interchange of I-35E to I-20. And I think that while they made vast improvements, they made these improvements to kind of try to fix some of the mistakes they made, because this project, like most of them, isn't just about the freeway expansion. It's about just reuniting the community, trying to actually make it work, and not trying to overdo it. Because in places like these, you don't need continuous surge roads. You don't need to have big ramps and everything, because this project was more focused on actually trying not to tear down the neighborhood more than they already had, whatever they originally built I-35E in these areas. So they decided to build a deck park, which will probably be close to how Clyde Warren Park looks, and they will be kind of identical. This one's supposed to look from like, it's supposed to be close to Dow Zoo, and it's supposed to have like two phases. Phase one, they already got the deck up, but they're building it currently, because even though freeway construction stopped in 2022, they have to start on the deck park, which they built the foundation for, but they're still trying to work on that, and that won't be finished until like 2026. But I'll get back to that later, but for now I think I'll talk about the improvements it made to the freeway. For starters, I-35E got 5 lanes in each direction and 2 reversible mandrels. So basically, reversible mandrels are basically like HOV lanes that run both ways that can be used for both directions but at different times, and they're free. Which is what they did with this project, especially since they're all free, they're not paid for. It's actually extra lane usage. And for US 67, they got expanded to 3 lanes each direction, one reversible HOV lane. And mostly continuous hard drug on US 67, because it didn't really cause too many problems with I-35 either. The parts it goes through leading up to its interchange to I-20. But the whole thing about this project is that it was meant to improve the area as a whole. It was meant to fix traffic conditions, because in this area traffic was very difficult. I did drive through it. I did see the area now multiple times when it was under construction, and it was very, very harsh, but they were actually very efficient, very quick with their work. They finished it in 4 years, opened it in like late 2022, started in 2018. And they did what they had to do to get the project done. Because whenever you actually, it shows how much they got done with this project, because they were actually trying to get it done, trying to report, but they're not improved anything until they open the deck part. I'm not saying this in a bad way, I'm just saying this in a... it's the next thing that they're working on, they have to do. Now I have to get on to probably the main reason why I made this video. Did it actually work? Did it actually clear up traffic? Is this another one of TxDOT's projects to just invite more urban sprawl into the area and hurt it? Well, here in September, so I guess 2022, 2 years after the last time I probably even mentioned this project in the History of Interstate video. But I'm gonna say it's pretty much better. Traffic's gotten better because with the reversible measurements actually being free and not being paid for, it's basically two lanes of free traffic to go through, and also with the 5 lanes in each direction, it helps a lot. There might not be a continuous front road, but that's okay because the area they're going through doesn't need to have a continuous front road because not everyone needs continuous front road to function well. And sometimes continuous front road can be detrimental and harmful to that area. And not every project needs to have one. Sometimes it can be discontinuous. Well, I'm pretty sure project work, you go over there, you see traffic is way more clear. Backups happen every now and then, but it's way clear, it's way more clear. You can drive on there way more quickly. Because I remember the first time seeing that place after a project was completed in November 2022. It was Zoom. It was like Zoom. It was so quick. Because you know how at first when projects get completed, it's super quick to drive through. It felt like that, and it was a very good experience to go on the freeway. The New Year's Eve 7 part. But I digress. So kind of the premise of all these projects is to improve the area, improve Southdale, John Dallas, improve the Metroplex as a whole. Because Metroplex is growing, it's still growing, but some places have been neglected more than others. And I think I'll try to stretch this video and make it 10 minutes long because I don't know, I don't have much more to talk about because I have to. Because my other videos kind of have more to talk about. But I will, I will say this was kind of needed because these sections of the freeway were built a long time ago. It kind of split the neighborhood. It's kind of a bad thing. It's kind of like a bad habit because we're kind of the same thing with East Dallas I-35E, east of I-35E. Looks like a bad habit, but it looks like they're trying to actually fix it with these projects. And eventually, down the line, maybe in 2030, maybe things will go back to normal. Maybe things will be a whole lot better. But for now, it's not looking good. It's not looking good. Because there's still lots of projects they have to do to even think of fixing some damage they've done to this area. It takes a while to plan that, it takes a while to stop that, it takes a while to get someone to build it, and it takes years to actually get to building. But I'm pretty confident that some work will get done. I don't think all the damage will be fixed, but some of the damage will be fixed, and that's what I'm kind of sure. So. So yeah, this project, I haven't actually talked about it in a single video. I haven't talked about it for its own video, even though I've kind of kept it a bit in my video since 2022. Now it's my voice starts to seem worse. We're up the last few minutes of the video talking about the US 67 part of it. So the 067 part is actually more complicated than you think. I did forget that there was a portion south of I-20 that they actually redid to 3 lanes while they're also working on the main Sun Gateway project. It was kind of like phase 2B or something, I don't know. No, but in all honesty, south of I-20 they expanded US 67. 3 lanes each direction, continuous road roads, U-turn lanes on some of the bridges, and while it wasn't a full depth reconstruction, like the other part, it was to alleviate traffic on this freeway, because it's a route that the people that come from downtown Dallas, go to Pleasant Hill, parts of South Dallas, parts of, other places too, because it's a very important freeway, so they upgraded it to 2 lanes. And more work will be done in that area, because eventually they're pretty sure they're probably going to upgrade the I-20 interchanges, because I-20's construction is coming, and I'll cover that in the future video. Probably, like, the video after next one, we will cover I-20, but for now, I'll be covering US-67 and I-35B. Final verdict, the project worked, but like every other project, it has its inconsistencies. No project is really perfect, but this one is one of the best, and I think it was very good. Next video, I'll talk about the urban interchanges project and how well that impacted. How quick that was done, because it was actually the quickest project I've ever seen.